Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play XCOM, Terror from the Deep. When we last left off, we had... Remember, the tank doesn't actually go up here. Yeah, it doesn't. The walls of this particular UFO have decided to be lined with fairy floss rather than actual, you know, whatever they use, you know, the Zerbite plate or whatever. So, iron armor, that's it. And because they decided not to use stuff that only a disruptor pulse rocket could get through, they decided to use stuff that a torpedo can go through. So we're just walked in the walls, basically. We're in a situation where we are basically ending turn momentarily, but hey, that is the situation. People have kindly informed me of the correct usage of the eye toys, sorry, the mind toys. A big flashing button comes up when we successfully mind control somebody, molecular control somebody. So let's enter. Someone fires a shot at our good friend. It hits twice, but fails to do any serious damage. So the ignorant newsreader shall continue the healing process, healing one final fatal wound. Excellent work. The sword is back up to parity. And the ignorant newsreader can put away that medikit. You can come on in. I forgot to think of an acronym before we started. No! I'll have to think of one momentarily. Ignore that moment of indecision. Aha, we see an enemy Gillman, and he doesn't know we're here. We can't do an aim shot, so let's just do a snap. It didn't work. Let's just crouch. Behind the cryogen units. Excellent. Let's enter. The ignorant newsreader puts that enemy down. Very well. Bit of a crossfire occurring here in the XCOM, in the alien submarine, but we are surviving very well. And as we know, ignorance is power. So the ignorant newsreader is making a short work of the enemy aliens as well. And now a good friend, Kings of Rome. Kings of Rome, yes. That works. Is coming in too. Oh dear, sword was eliminated. Crossfire to extreme. Oh, it's regrettable. But we must press on. The ignorant newsreader has taken a hit, but not really taken any damage. And lots of the enemies have been eliminated. We must move from pointy stick forwards in order to gain some extra visibility in the situation here. Alright, you just stand there, ignorant newsreader. And now the King of Rome shall now advance. Oh no, he can't. No Kings of Rome. We're going to attempt to try and blast another hole in this wall. That didn't work. Next time we'll aim for the wall. A shot was fired from this direction. Ah, here you are. Goodbye. The ignorant newsreader sorts them out. Sorts them out. Like a good newsreader should. The teleprompter tells her which enemies to eliminate, and she does so very well. No line of fire? How about that? That didn't work. Not that time. Strange happenings, eh? Well, if we have to miss out on having the Coelacanth goodness this time, we have to miss out on the Coelacanth goodness this time. Either way, we have eliminated a great number of enemy aliens. And now the King of Rome comes forth. I do hope it's okay, King of Rome, that I'm inventing your name up all the time. I'm sure there's an actual meaning. One of those things that was lost a through translation from year to year. But we'll get there. Let's enter. And there is silence on the deck on the alien ship. No enemies to be found at any time. Pointy Stick says nothing to see here. But is there something to see over here? Maybe. It might be time to have some additional reinforcements. So we shall have our good friend, Dove. Dove can come out. Dove does not need to reserve time units, and Dove can make his way to the door. To the door. Come on, Dove. Thank you. Otherwise, there's nothing really invisibility to molecular control, so we'll just call it a turn. Ah, there's an alien there. But the King of Rome unleashed a powerful attack, instantly disabling it. Good on you, Rome. The Pointy Stick now ventures forth, investigating this particular closet. And there is nothing. Nothing to see there. The Pointy Stick is satisfied. Many things have been pointed at with a stick. Okay, the Ignorant Newsreader. It's time to move on to the next level. Well, not yet, but soon. Okay, now the King of Rome, where are you? I'm sorry, no, Dove. Dove needs to come out. A bit more. King of Rome's done well. Let's enter. Turn 22. So far, so good indeed. A great many bodies litter this lift. It's a Gilman soldier with a sonic cannon. Nothing to see so far up here, but for the want of caution, we shall quickly run for it. As well as the Pointy Stick, who continues to navigate around the UFO. It's a submarine, actually, but yes, an unidentified swimming object, as some would say. Or an unidentified submerged object, which is a bit more military. That depends how you are. Some people like military time, some people don't. It's just all different depending on who you are. Turn 23, and things continue to go well for the forces of XCOM. We have lost one noble Aquanaut, but otherwise, life goes on. Meanwhile, the Ignorant Newsreader and the King of Rome are now poised to enter the lift. They are poised. Very poised. Actually, I don't think that's poised enough. Just come on down again. That's good. Alright. And of course, we can't forget Dove, who is needed in case we need reinforcements. Alright, let's end turn once again. After we've done that. Turn 24. We are doing well. Come on down, Pointy Stick. There's more iron beam accelerators here than you can point a stick at. That's right. The Pointy Stick says there's nothing on this floor that's left alive. Well, left active at least. Let's move on. Ignorant Newsreader moves up two floors. Quickly checks there's nothing behind her back. And then stands poised, ready to retaliate. As for the King of Rome, he shall zero his time units. So that he doesn't accidentally fire at somebody. Because we don't want a stun round going off in our face. Dove shall now continue to make his way towards the enemy alien craft. And then place himself in a position where he is able to at least look inside. His energy's gone. Swine energy. Alright. Let's enter. The top floor. And what excitement awaits us all. Nothing over there. We don't want to take another step, so we'll leave you there. Okay. What we'll do is we'll call it a video here, and when we come back, the final floor.